Breaking news comes to us from Washington, D.C., where a Capitol Police officer is dead and another is hospitalized after they were rammed by a vehicle outside the U.S. Capitol earlier today. And investigators say the suspect is also dead. Thanks for joining us here on this Friday at 4 o'clock. I'm Rob Bezier along with Cheryl Miller and Julie Bragg. Here's what we know right now. According to Capitol Police, at 1:02 p.m., the suspect rammed his car into the officers and hit the barricade at the Constitution Avenue access point to the Capitol. They say the man then exited his car with a knife in hand and lunged at the U.S. Capitol Police officers, who then fired upon the suspect. All three were taken to the hospital. As we mentioned, one officer has died from their injuries. We do not know the condition of the second officer, and the suspect is also dead. The Metropolitan Police Department is taking over the investigation.
At this time, it does not appear to be an ongoing threat. Obviously, we're in the very early stages of our investigation. We need to obviously understand the motivation behind this senseless act. So the Metropolitan Police Department will certainly be doing that.
Well, shortly after the incident began, police sent an alert to congressional staffers warning them of an external security threat. Within about an hour and a half, police sent another alert saying the threat had been neutralized. The incident comes nearly 3 months after rioters overran the U.S. Capitol building in a deadly attack back on January 6th, which resulted in the deaths of five people, including a Capitol Police officer. Fencing was erected around the Capitol following the attack back then, but the security fencing was taken down last week. A layer of inner fencing around the Capitol building itself remains in place. And make sure you stay with CBS 6.